In order to find the resultant force and coordinate direction angle of the couple of forces acting along the line, we can start by first figuring out the point coordinates of the head and tail of the force vector. So to start, point A lies at a distance of 4 feet along the y-axis, so the point coordinates will be 0, 4, 0, whereas point B lies at a distance of 2 feet in the x direction and negative 6 in the z direction. Point C also lies on our xz plane at a distance of 2.5 feet, whereas the vertical distance can be calculated from the right angle triangle of 13, 12, and 5. Since 2.5 is half of 5, using the same ratio, the vertical distance will be half of 12. That will be 6 in this case. Next, we can go ahead and calculate the unit vector UAC, that is equal to the position vector divided by the magnitude of the position vector. The position vector is calculated by doing the head minus tail. So we subtract the point coordinates of C with the point coordinates of A and divide it with the magnitude of that position vector. Once we have the unit vector, multiplying it with the magnitude of the force, that is 80 pounds in this case, give us the force F1 in the Cartesian vector form. Now we will repeat the same process for our force F2 by calculating the position vector of RAB and dividing it with the magnitude of RAB to calculate the unit vector of AB. Once we have the unit vector, we will again multiply that with the magnitude of force F2 of 50 pounds to calculate the force F2 in the Cartesian vector form. That is coming as 13.4i, negative 26.7j, and negative 40.1k. Now, once we have both the forces in the Cartesian vector form, we can go ahead and add them together to figure out the resultant force in the Cartesian vector form. In this case, the I component will be added with the I component, the J component will be added with the J component, and the K component will be added with the K component. So our resultant force is coming as negative 12.8i, negative 68.7j, and 22.8k. Now, once we have the Cartesian form, we can go ahead and also calculate the magnitude of this force, because we will require that magnitude to calculate our coordinate angles. Now, for coordinate angles, alpha, beta, and gamma are the angles that the force make along the x, y, and z axis respectively. So to calculate that, alpha is the cos inverse of the x component of the resultant force divided by the magnitude of the force, and it is coming around as 100 degrees. Similarly, we can calculate beta and gamma by utilizing the y and z component of the resultant force.